welcome. As you can see, my name is Parvez, Parvez Daruwala. Please feel free to call me by my name. Okay. How many of you know about TAT? Anybody knows about it? Have you heard of it before, tried it, practiced it?
Heart Nobody? Field therapy, is it?
No. No, that's different.
Yes.
Okay, that's TFT. This is TAT. Okay?
I know it's something to do with the three fingers.
Okay.
Something like that.
Yes, wonderful. Okay. So, I'll be sharing about TAT and we'll also do a couple of quick demonstrations and see how it works for you, right? So before we go ahead, I always like to know who I am speaking with, and I'll request each one of you to very quickly just share your names and what you do in life. A few faces are familiar, because I keep coming and giving some talks, but some of them are new also. So shall we begin with the ladies? Ladies first.
I'm Pushpa Majula. I'm a life coach and a psychologist.
Finance company. Finance company, you're interested in alternate healing? How interesting. That's
I've done
nice.
Dhanic healing and Reiki and
also. Okay. Sure, great. Yes.
I'm Naina Thakkar. I'm a kindergarten teacher. Right now I'm not working for the last 6 months.
Great.
Jayat engineer. I gave you the last lecture on that excess
bus.
Keep healthy prior to now.
Of course.
I'm Shirish Mungre, working as a management consultant and a regular visitor over here.
Yes.
I do a biography of chairman of company.
Sorry, repeat that.
I do a biography of chairman of company.
Okay.
I write for people.
Yes, great. Why don't you tell us your name?
Hari.
Yes, I know. The rest of us also need to know.
My name is Lars.
I'm retired from Sibagai. From? Sibagai. Okay. All right. Wonderful. So are we ready to understand what this is all about? Yes? It's a very simple system actually. And I have used it, I've practiced it, I've shared it with different people, and it gives you interesting results. So first of all, what does TAT mean? And TAT stands for Tapas Acupressure Technique. Okay. Why Tapas? Because the person who discovered it, her name is Tapas. Or at least she goes by the name of Tapas now. So, Tapas Fleming. Now, she was going through some difficult period in her life. A lot of health issues she was having. And she was more keen to heal herself through natural methods rather than through allopathic and surgical methods. So she kind of just kept looking for how she can go about doing things better for herself. And she kept on asking the universe, asking God, asking life, show me something which will be helpful, which will be non-invasive, which will be simple, which will be quick, and so on and so forth. And one day she just kind of received this methodology as a form of inspiration. Maybe while she was meditating or something, she kept working on it and so on and so forth, refined it. She conducted a couple of workshops with a few people and she found it works pretty well.
She's an Indian?
No, she is in America. Okay.
What is her name, you say? Tapas.
Tapas.
T-A-P-A-S.
Yes.
So in Sanskrit, it's Tapas.
Yeah. So maybe she's taken that as a name, I don't know. But now she calls herself Tapas Fleming. Okay. So now how does TAT work? TAT works on many, many issues, physical, emotional, psychological, etc. And it also works on life issues like, say, finances, like relationships, because essentially it also works on the whole element of our belief system, right? So when you have a system like, say, as you spoke of Reiki, which is again an all-encompassing system, these work on all the platforms which you require when you are working on something called as healing, right? So what do we understand by the term healing? There are many, many healing methodologies if you look at it today. So, just to understand, what do we mean by this term?
That we are all wounded.
Okay, that's one way to look at it. Yes, and therefore...
Therefore, we know that we are being battled deliberately, which means that they are in the system.
Who is they?
The ones who are creating the healing sciences. Mm-hmm. Because they are aware of the battering that we are taking.
Yeah, and often as I told you, the example of Tapas, she herself was going through a time which you could say as a battering from life, and she kept on seeking and searching.
I don't know whether it is life or whether it is the system, because I am coming to the conclusion that the system is deliberately turning the screws on individuals.
Fine. Okay. So, we can all have a different points of views and perspectives, and that's fine. And every perspective is
actually, I did a course of 12 days for tapasana.
Vipassana. Yes.
And I tell you, it was a wonderful experience.
Sure. So maybe what you should do, Hari, is one day come and talk to people on Vipassana. Yeah.
Okay.
Right now, please allow me to go back.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. And TAT. So, what do we do in TAT? Essentially, in TAT, we work with the energy of the body, right? The energy system of the body. And it's pretty simple. You begin working with placing three fingers in this fashion over here. Okay, so you take the thumb, you take the ring finger, and you take the mid finger. This is the ring finger. The ring finger and the thumb on two sides of the bridge of the nose, and the thumb on top over here. Okay, this is called a TAT pose, TATPOSE. And then you take the other hand and you place it behind over here. Okay, that is where your head and neck start meeting at this juncture, right? So this is called the TAT pose.
Finger,
huh?
This way?
1, 2, and 3.
Yes.
These three.
Last three. Yeah. Two last and this.
No. This.
Okay.
Okay. This.
Okay.
Okay. And this.
Okay.
Right? And there could be specific reasons why just these three fingers is what she's recommending. And when you look into the Indian science of mudra, those of you who are familiar with it would know that each of the fingers stands for different elements, right? So, for example, this is for fire, this is air, this is sky, this is earth, and this is water, right? So, we are working with these three elements for TAT. And again, with the other hand, we are placing all of them over here. So, once again, we are bringing into the picture all the other five elements also, right? So, now this is the TAT pose, TAT pose. What happens after this is, there are various statements we say, right? When you place your fingers like this and your hand at the back like this, what you're doing is you're generating the healing energy within the body, and with some of the actual statements which you will speak of, it starts creating the healing process. So, what I'd like to do is, I'd like to request one of you to volunteer to come here, and I will take you through that. Would like to come quickly. But do you have an issue?
Not much.
Ah, so somebody with some issue, please come. That would be better. Okay.
And how long is the whole process?
About 20-30 minutes. Yeah. So come on, can I have somebody very quickly? It's safe, so there's nothing to worry about.
Okay.
Please come. Yes, of course. Right? So now, Sangeeta, right?
Naina.
Okay. Oh, you're Sangeeta. Now, what I'd like you to do is just do the TAT pose, right? And place the other hand at the back, right? Relax, close your eyes, and just relax. The rest of you can actually watch right now, and then I'll take you through one where we all do one together, or you can do it along with us. Now, what I'd like you to do is think of some situation which you need not tell us, but something which is probably bothering you at the physical level, emotional or mental level, okay? So just think of it and keep in mind that this is a situation we'd like to do the healing for today. Clear? Also, I'd like you to understand that one session may not be 100% enough. Right? This is something one needs to do a little more regularly. Right? But this should give you some relief to start off with. Okay. So what I'd like you to do and say is that, say this along with me,
this healing which I'm doing
is helping my ancestors,
my family,
myself, all the points of view I ever held, yeah,
okay.
and anybody else who could benefit from this, right? Okay, now take a nice little deep breath and relax, and say this now. That is too simple and easy to work and have any results. Okay. Now, very often when people are doing this for the first time and they see it's so simple, there's a doubt in their mind. So we are actually stating the doubt, we are stating it aloud, and we are letting it go. Right? So that's what we have done. Now, that is easy and will help me out.
That is easy and will help me out.
Right. And I
deserve to live.
And heal myself and be happy. Okay, fine. Okay, so now take a nice slowly breath. Exhale. And every time you want to breathe out, want to breathe in, just feel free to do that. Okay? Now once again, please think of the issue which you would like to get some relief from. Right? Is it something you want to share with us, or you want to keep it to yourself?
Choice is up
to you.
It's lack of communication with someone.
Okay.
You know, I know that there's bottled up feelings on the other side.
All right.
And I want to confront.
You know? So who do you want to confront? You want to confront that other person?
Yeah.
So what is the result you're looking for? Are you clear on that?
Communication.
You want to communicate
open
better?
Open communication.
You want to have open communication. Okay, wonderful. So something has happened which has led to communication not being open.
I mean, there's no resentment or anything. It's just that, you know, when there's no communication, you feel kind of a kind of a barrier.
Sure. So now I'd like you to say, this is the first step which we are doing now, is just say, this happened.
This happened.
Right. We are referring to this particular issue in your life, which is the lack of communication and all the resultant issues from it. Okay.
But that means you have to say...
No, you don't have to say the whole thing.
What I said, you have to say in your mind.
Or you can say, you have to say in your mind, or you can say even upfront, right?
Okay.
Because we are all observing and watching.
Okay.
You can say, so that you're, you know, along with me, and I know you're doing it correctly.
Right.
So once again, this happened.
This happened.
Okay. Now just keep your focus mentally for a few moments on that situation. And whenever you feel the need for, just take a nice slow deep breath and breathe out. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to step two. Now say this. This happened.
This happened.
It's over.
It's over.
I'm fine.
I'm fine.
And I can relax now.
I can relax now.
So though in real life it may still not have happened, right? We are actually saying, and we are creating energetically the situation that this has happened and it's over now. So that it doesn't continue to irritate and bother us and the resolution happens. Fine?
Yeah.
So once again, this happened.
This happened.
It's over.
It's over.
I can relax now.
I can relax now.
I'm fine now.
I'm fine now.
I'm fine.
I'm fine.
Okay. So now be with the whole energy that this is over, this is complete. And you can relax. And also, whenever you want to change the position of your hands, which means bring this hand in front and the other, just do that, okay?
Okay. But you have to have it on all the
time. Yes, you must keep breathing. Yeah. Right. Okay? Okay, so let's go to the next one. All the places.
In my life.
In my body. And everywhere else. Where this was an issue. Are healing now. So as I even say this, Nena, I hope you're also listening to what it means.
Yeah.
Right? Great.
I'm visualizing those places.
Fair enough. So once again, all the places.
In my life.
In my body.
And everywhere else.
Where this happened.
Are healing now.
If somebody believes in God or a higher power and would like to, you know, allow God or that higher power to do the healing for you, then instead of saying, in the way we said, you can just say that I thank God for healing this in all the places it's happening, etc. So there's some people bring in the whole idea of God also. Fine? Okay. So breathe in and breathe out. And remember, whenever you want to change your hand, you can. Okay? This is now healing.
this is now healing?
From all its origins.
From all its origins.
This is now healing?
This is now healing.
From all its origins.
From all its origins.
Okay, so now I'll give you that God statement in case somebody likes to thank God. So it's like something like this, okay? Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For healing this.
For healing this.
From all its origins.
From all its origins.
Right? And whenever you feel there's a shift in the energy, where you feel a little bit of shift inside you, within you, just take a nice deep breath and exhale. Right? Okay. We're going to the fifth step, and the fifth step has four statements. Right? The first one of the fifth step, let's say A, is, and this is interesting for you, all communications and connections.
All communications and connections.
With regard to this,
with regard to this,
are complete now.
Are complete now.
Okay. Next, I apologize.
I apologize.
To whomever.
To whomever.
I have hurt.
I have hurt.
With regard to this.
With regard to this.
I forgive.
I forgive.
Whoever has hurt me.
Whoever has hurt me.
With regard to this.
With regard to this.
And I forgive.
And I forgive.
Myself.
Myself.
God.
God.
And whoever else.
And whoever else.
I blamed.
I blamed.
With regard to this.
With regard to this.
Now the interesting thing, friends, is that you don't have to believe all these statements which you have done, okay? But it's part of the process that we just say. What happens is, when we are saying it also, the energy starts operating and working, creating the right neurological, whatever changes have to happen. Okay? How are you feeling at this point?
Good. I can feel some surge of energy.
Okay, wonderful. Right, next one, okay? Whatever I got out of this,
whatever I got out of this,
is healing now.
Is healing now.
Or the other way to put it is, thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For healing.
For healing.
Whatever I got out of this.
Whatever I got out of this.
Yeah. You'll understand the meaning of this statement. You know, sometimes we call upon illnesses on us, or we kind of get a payoff or some kind of a benefit out of falling sick or out of creating a difficult situation in life, because we get some advantage sometimes.
A payoff,
right? And because we want the payoff more than wanting to be healed, we don't allow ourselves to get healed. Whatever modality of healing we use, right? So you know what we are saying is that whatever benefit I got, whether it's a dubious benefit or a payoff kind of benefit, I am ready to let it go, and I'm just going to focus on being completely, totally healed. Fine?
Right.
Shall we go on?
Yes.
Okay. So that was the sixth statement about releasing all benefits and payoffs. And the seventh one is, whatever is left of this,
whatever is left of this,
is healing now.
Is healing now.
So we are presupposing that in the six earlier statements, the healing has already begun and it's working on us. But if there's something still left, that is also getting released and healed. Fine. So thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For healing.
For healing.
Whatever is left of this.
Whatever is left of this.
Right. And remember, the God statements are like options. If you don't believe in God, you don't have to say it. If you believe in God and if you want to say it, yes, and you can do both of them together. Choice is totally yours. Right? Okay. Now, this one, just listen, this is the eighth one. And I want you to be clear on what you want out of this situation now then. Okay? So I'm going to say, I choose.
I choose.
And now you have to say what you want to happen in this situation.
I choose to confront and know what is holding him back.
Okay, fine. So I choose to confront and know what is holding him back. You want to have a better relationship, better communication, right? So in simple words, I choose to have a better relationship with open and effective communication, right? Okay, so can we just once again state that clearly? I choose.
I choose.
Yeah, please say it.
I choose to confront and know what is holding him back.
Okay, fine. Now, I'd like you to shift your hands once again. Okay? This is the ninth step, and the ninth step, you actually shift the hands. But that pose remains, right? And now you say, this healing is complete.
This healing is complete.
Now. This healing is completely integrated now.
This healing is completely integrated now.
And if you want the God statement, then you can say, thank you, God.
And thank you, God.
For completely integrating this healing now.
For completely integrating this healing now.
Yeah. Keep the pose for a few moments. Take a few slow deep breaths and exhale. Now, I'd like you to move your hands away and keep them behind your ears. Behind your ears. You can take a look at what I'm doing, like this. Okay, so cup your ears. Yeah, like this. Yeah, there are certain pressure points there which are probably getting activated. And just once again, close your eyes and relax. And you can say, I give thanks for this healing.
I give thanks for this healing.
To. And whoever you want to say, so you can say God, your soul, your higher self, yourself, whatever. Okay, so that's your choice. So I give thanks for this healing to.
I give thanks for this healing to.
And whoever it is. You can say that loudly or in your mind.
To God.
Okay. And slowly you can move your hands out. Come back. Open your eyes and come back. Bye. So that's one session of tap. Okay, now again it depends on each situation, right, and what it is for. Sometimes it works very, very quickly, and even just one session is pretty enough and pretty good. Right?
So
how are you feeling? Yes. How are you feeling? So you have anxiety, there's no communication, right?
It's now less stressed.
Less stressed.
I feel that there's a solution.
You feel there's a solution.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, I feel that I can handle it.
Wonderful. So can you just give her a big round of applause? Thank you.
So combination of some Ho'oponopono?
No, this is really not Ho'oponopono over here, because I know Ho'oponopono also, and I've been working with this also. So I don't see any direct similarities. Yeah, the only similarity you could say probably is about we work with statements here, we work with statements there also, yeah. But the statements are totally different, and the common link probably is the whole aspect of forgiveness. Mm-hmm. So step 5 over here is all about communication and forgiveness. Okay? Fine. So now would all of us like to practice this for ourselves? I did this as a demo so you can see how it goes, but does anybody want to now do this along with me? So you pick up your own issues and I'll take you through that. You can work with the same one, Naina, so you know it continues to have more effect, or the choices you can do something else. Right? Are we ready?
Yeah.
So let me just say, TAT works on physical issues also, emotional issues, mental issues, and also life issues. Like you said, you're a life coach. So you know, sometimes people have some of these issues in life. So maybe you can try this also and work it out. Right? So is everyone ready? We'd like to work with it?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. So remember, what is a TAT pose? This is the ring finger, the thumb, and the middle finger over here. And the other hand, like this. Okay, everyone got that? Right? Right. So, once you do this, please keep your eyes closed. It is suggested you keep your eyes closed so you don't lose out energy. Yeah. And middle finger touching your... Not so high, you can bring it a little lower. Yeah, but wherever it is convenient to each one of you, you know, essentially we are looking at in the area of what we call as the third eye in the field of chakras. Right, everyone ready? Yes? Okay. So we'll say the first statement. This healing works
for my ancestors,
my family,
my life, my body.
All points of view that I've ever held,
and everybody else
who could benefit from this. Right? Great. So just hold that. And I hope all of you have thought of some issue you want to work with. Okay? Great. Now, For most of you are doing this for the first time, so you will say, that is too easy and simple to work.
That is too easy and simple to work.
And show results.
And show results.
Okay, now please take a slow deep breath and exhale. Exhale out the energy of disbelief. Okay, next. That is simple.
To use
and gives effective results.
Wonderful.
And
I
deserve to
live and be happy.
I am grateful. Okay. Now continue to keep your tat pose, but please remember, whenever you want to shift your hands, it means bring this hand in front and take that hand at the back. Feel free to do that anytime during the session, right? Okay. So now we're going to do the first statement of tat, which is, this happened. So think of what you are wanting to heal and just say, this particular situation happened. So just say it in your mind, this happened.
This happened.
Yeah. It could be like you could have fallen down something and hurt yourself, you could have had a fight with someone, or you could have lost money in business and that is upsetting you. Whatever. Or an actual physical or emotional illness or situation. So this happened, right? And keep your focus on this happened. After a few moments, say about half a minute to a minute, breathe in and breathe out. So you are releasing the energy of this happened. Okay? So everyone just take a nice slow deep breath and exhale completely. Done? Great. I'm moving to the next step. The next step is, and say this along with me please, this happened.
This happened.
It's over now.
It's over now.
I am fine. And I can relax now.
And I can relax now.
So think of these words. This has happened. ठीक है हो गया है अब खत्म हो गया है. Now that it is over, I'm fine. I can relax, and everything is well with me and my life. Okay. So that's what we are saying in the second statement. So let's repeat that. This happened.
This happened.
It's over now.
It's over now.
I'm fine.
I'm fine.
And I can relax now.
And I can relax now.
I can be happy now.
I can be happy now.
I'm grateful now.
I'm grateful now.
Fine. Shall we move on? Next statement. Wherever. In my life.
In my life.
Body. Etc.
Etc.
This happened.
This happened.
It is healing now.
It is healing now.
And if you like, now we bring the God statements here. So this is something, here we will say something like this. Thank you God.
Thank you God.
For healing this.
For healing this.
From all the places.
From all the places.
In my life.
In my life.
In my body.
In my body.
And everywhere else around. So remember to breathe in and breathe out. And we go to the fourth one. The fourth one is, this is healing.
This is healing.
From all its origins.
From all its origins.
So very often we don't really know where something happened in our life, you know, like an illness or any other situation. And those who like to believe in past lives would like to say that, oh well, this could also be because of some things which happened in past lives, right? Or it could have happened when you were very, very small. So wherever it happened and something triggered it off, this is healing all the way from the origins of it, right? So we'll do the God statement now. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For healing this.
For healing this.
From its origins.
From its origins.
So we are not only saying that we are using ourselves as a conduit for healing ourselves, but we are also actually giving credit to God or a higher power and expressing gratitude for that. Right? So take a nice slow deep breath, exhale, and just check how you're feeling. Check how you're feeling physically, emotionally, mentally. Just be aware of that. Now let's move on to statement 5. Statement 5, as I said earlier, has 4 sub-statements. And the first one is, all communications
and
connections
with
regard to this
are
healing now.
Are complete now.
So I'll repeat that.
All communications and connections
with regard to this
are healing.
And complete now.
I apologize
to all those whom I have hurt
with regard to this.
Breathe in, breathe out. Next, I forgive
all those
who have hurt me.
Who have hurt me.
With regard to this. So, we seek forgiveness and we give forgiveness. And fifth D, I forgive
myself,
God,
and whoever else,
or whatever else,
I blame for this.
So once again, please breathe in, breathe out. So very often it's difficult for us to take full responsibility for what happens in our life. And the easiest thing is to blame something or somebody else, right? Including we sometimes blame God also. So here we are seeing we are releasing all the blame game and we are just moving into a state of forgiveness. Okay, sixth one. Whatever I got out of this
is healing now.
So this is the one where we said we may get a payoff or a dubious benefit, which prevents us from actually allowing ourselves to get completely healed. So whatever I got out of this
is healing now.
Thank you, God,
for healing.
Whatever I got out of this. Breathe in, breathe out. And remember, when you want to change your hands, feel free to do that anytime you want. We go to statement 7. Whatever else is still left of this
is healing now.
So any remnants, any little bits, pieces, atoms, cells, molecules, energy, trickles, whatever is still left of this, we're completely healing it and releasing it and letting it go. So thank you God
for healing
whatever is left of this. Now we go to statement 8, and here you have to think of what you want instead of this situation in your life. So we will say I choose, and then you have to say whatever it is that you choose. So like in the earlier example, you recollect Naina wanted a better communication and relationship with whoever the person is over there, right? So you have to choose what it is. So if it's a physical ailment, it becomes simple to think, okay, I want a relief from my headache, or I want a relief from whatever it is. If it's emotional thing, once again, so just be aware of what it is you want to choose. And each one of you can say this either loudly or in your mind. Okay, are we ready? Has everyone thought of what you want?
Yeah.
Everyone?
Yeah.
Are you all clear? Yes? And say that in a simple statement. You have to say the statement very simply so that you're giving your mind and your energy a very simple instruction of what you want, nothing complicated. Right? So see that your statement is not very, very long or complex. Are we ready? Great. I choose. And now say whatever it is you want, either in your mind or loudly. Have you all made your statements, completed your statements in your mind? Yes, everyone? Just kind of nod your heads, please, so I know. Okay, wonderful. Everyone's done. Great. Now, please change your hands. So this hand, take back and bring that hand in the front. Maintain the tat position, but change your hands. This is the ninth step, and this is when we change hands deliberately. Now we will say, this healing
is
complete.
Is complete
now.
Now.
And it's completely integrated.
It's completely integrated.
So thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For healing.
For healing.
Me completely.
Me completely.
So thank you, God, for healing me completely and integrating this completely in my life.
Integrating this completely in my life.
Right. So feel a sense of gratitude for being healed. And now gently move your hands away and place them behind your ears, like I showed you earlier. All of them, all the fingers behind your ears, like this if you'd like to see. Just open your eyes and take a look. Right? So just place your fingertips there for some time. Bring your focus on your breathing. And feel that you have been healed. Whatever the situation is, it is healing. You have at least taken the first step towards a healing, a recovery. So, once again, we will express a gratitude. So, thank you for healing.
Thank you for healing.
So, now you may want to express gratitude to whoever you'd like to thank. So, people may like to thank God or a higher power or a saint or a sage or your own soul or your own self, right? So you can say something like, thank you God, thank you my higher self, thank you my soul, thank you my mind, thank you my body, thank you myself for this healing. So it's your choice, but the idea is we stay in a state of gratitude. Okay? Yeah, and whenever you're done, you can slowly move your hands away, open your eyes and come back. So how are you all feeling? Can I have a few people share?
Like I said, I felt like I can handle it better now. I may even straight away confront without feeling any resentment. You know, I
exactly
inches
a lot. Yes, wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Great, thank you. And this feeling continued after the second time also? Very nice. Anybody else would like to share?
For me,
yes,
a lost of memory came up,
okay.
which is a very, very chronic problem in my life, which is my relationship with money.
Okay.
And in spite of having a lot, I don't have liquidity or, you know, and I've put myself in that situation. And suddenly the memory came back to me as to when I felt that and why it happened and how it happened. It happened when I was in third standard.
Okay.
So the thing, I didn't realize that this would do this to me, but it did it. And it helped me locate the point at which I made some feeling which was very intense. But the resolution, I don't know if it's happened, but the intention is there,
yes,
to resolve it. And at least it brought it to focus as to when it started.
Right.
So that was a major thing that happened to me.
Wonderful. Let's hear it forward. So I want to share it. And just one of the things with that, you may have memories coming up, like she said. And these are memories about what led to the situation. Remember, somewhere along we are saying the origins. We are healing from the origins.
But it's also a systematic problem. It's not just me putting myself in that situation, but it's also the system that is doing it. It's a combined, but I can see that.
Yes. So you could probably handle your part. System, you may not be able to handle.
No, I can. I can handle
fine.
It.
Wonderful. Okay. All right. So, anybody else would like to share, sir?
My problem of again money, lot of money outside.
Okay.
So after doing that, I feel a state of expectation. Something
okay.
Is wrong.
Great. Nice. So, as I said, you can see this even for situations like money issues, right? We work on a relationship and communication issue. People work on this for actual physical illnesses and that works very well on, I'm told, allergy issues, interestingly.
Mm.
Okay, so anybody has an allergy, please help them with that.
Well, I have allergic problems. If I have regular food like peanuts,
okay. So you know what the situation is. It's an allergy to, say, peanuts.
Okay.
Right? So this happened. What happened? Allergy to peanuts happened. And that's how you take it forward. Right? So practice. Did you use this right now for the allergy thing? Or something else?
What about psoriasis? Does this work with psoriasis?
You could try it. I believe it works pretty well on allergies and skin-related issues. So I think that's also a skin-related thing. And some of you would be aware, like those of you who are in the healing field would know that most of the skin-related issues, at the back of them, are all emotional issues.
Psychosomatic.
Yeah. Okay, so as we know, psychosomatic is, psycho is the mind, somatic is the body, the combination of the two. Right? Okay, so fine. Anybody else would like to share?
I could just feel the, I didn't get the origin of the problem.
That's not, you
but
don't
I could feel in Reiki and how we get the particular light, you know.
Uh-huh.
What do you say, healing light, purple color light just coming into you. Which is what we call as a healing light coming down to you. That's what I felt at the.
Okay, fine.
That was a good feeling, a very relaxed feeling.
Right. Great. So, any other thoughts, any other questions?
Now, verbal communication, I mean, verbal self-communication, you say. The 9 steps. So, that has to be. I want to know the summary of each step without getting any statement. First step is for.
See, the first time. Sorry. The first time you do that, first time in your life you do that, you invoke that this will heal you all the way through your ancestors and all of that. Because, I don't know how many of you are ready to believe this. But sometimes certain issues in life come through our ancestors. We can see that in terms of physiological and genetic illnesses, right? But apart from that, also other issues flow through ancestry lines, like emotional and mental issues. And then there are also things like situation issues. So like, you know, fights in families or money issues, all of that sometimes, strangely enough, come through our ancestry line. So here we are going all the way back over there and saying we're even healing that. So the first statement is, this healing works on my ancestors. Everything else in life, including all the points of views, which is all the beliefs I have.
Can we add that past karmas?
You can add anything, sir. Right? Because these are all energy systems. Your intention is what kind of works pretty well. This is a guideline. Okay? Then we say the 3 statements where... Suppose
so just one thing.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is, can you record or can you write?